I've been wanting to do this video on my son's Gibson for a while. And in the meantime, I had an auction item come in, this Ventura Bruno guitar. And it really kind of highlights the difference between cool old and vintage old. I think everybody would agree that Gibson and the tradition and the quality that went into their guitars is pretty legendary. And here we have a great example of the Gibson Hummingbird and a Gibson Hummingbird knockoff. So the one on the right, the really, cherry red, is made in Japan. And we'll go through that. I'll have a video on the sounds of that guitar. But I thought it was kind of funny to juxtapose my ideas around vintage. And there are going to be some people who probably will really like the sound of this Ventura guitar. I do. It's not the same kind of resonant beast that the Gibson is, and you'll see when I go to play it, it's really, really beautiful guitar. And my son just loves dead strings, so we're gonna hear it with some dead strings. I told him I would restring it for him since it's here at my house, and I'm gonna do kind of a close-up on it. Some of the stuff I really love about this Gibson. I don't know if you can tell, but the fretboard is awesome. It is so beautifully made. It has the inlaid top. I know some of the guitars of Gibson that are vintage from the era come back and they have that gold leaf. But this also has fat frets on it. And I just love it. I love the fat frets on this guitar. I think it's awesome. You know, it has that old, I guess it's celluloid, that vintage scratch plate. So this is a 1967 Hummingbird. It has all this beautiful checking on it. What an awesome guitar. It does have some mismatched tuning pegs, which I think is kind of funny. My son is not the kind of guy to really care about that either. And it just has this beautiful aged checked finish on the sides of the guitar. It has all that yellowing of the binding. And it just has this really pretty cherry back on it. Cherry colored. I'm 100% that it's mahogany, but it's such a beautiful guitar. And it was owned by a professional musician. He was a session guy. He was down in, I believe he's in Nashville. My son bought this used, obviously, from a music shop nearby called Russo Music. But this is what happens when you have those nitrocellulose finishes on the guitar. I mean, at some point, he's probably going to have to consider what to do about the binding. I know some of these old, the plastic begins to degrade, and then at some point, he'll need to have somebody do new binding on it. And then here we have this Bruno, this Ventura guitar. It's really clean. I cleaned it up. I don't, it almost looked like there were teeth marks up there. I don't know if somebody bit the top of that guitar. I have no idea what happened. But this is old, just of the time. A nice guitar made in Japan, copying Gibson. I think this is a little bit more of that harmony style body shape. I don't know that Gibson ever made a body that was this shape, although maybe. It's kind of interesting. It has a different waist to it. This has a higher waist. But again, I think they must have used a poly finish on it where you had a nitrocellulose lacquer finish on the Gibson. It came in with an issue. There's some kind of cracking over here. It got beat up a little bit. But it too has a really nice mahogany back on it. I can't say if it's solid mahogany, but what I do like about this guitar is the neck. Has a really nice mahogany neck, single piece, decent tuning pegs, gets the job done. And we'll give them a play, but clearly the guitar of the moment is this Gibson Hummingbird from 1967. Just an awesome guitar. I've been waiting to play it for my channel. And I was kind of considering using it as it's the benchmark for true vintage. Vintage is old that gets better with age, and then there's just cool old. So there's, I guess there's two types of vintage. And then there's, of course, there's just old crap, which is just old junk, right? So these are beautiful guitars. I think the Ventura is kind of funky. I have a tendency to think that if they take the time to do an inlay on the top, that you're probably getting a little better instrument than if they're trying to save some money on it. But there it is. It still has the original bridge and saddle on there. It looks like another rosewood saddle. I don't know if he'd ever consider replacing it with a bone, but we'll see. We're going to give it a play. There it is. What a beautiful, beautiful guitar. So while I have this Gibson, I want to show it to you. I mean, this is what a real vintage guitar looks like. I'm going to do another video, but this is just going to go in the montage of the videos that I'm going to make as an homage to this 1967 Gibson Hummingbird. And who knows what my playing is going to be like. Anybody who plays knows. Some days you got it. Some days you don't. Like this guitar, and the strings are dead, and I think that's the way my son likes it, but he's gonna have to get a new set of strings on it for this video. There's some mismatched tuning pegs back here. I mean, maybe they're all bone and that's all good. It does have an adjustable bridge saddle. It's interesting, and I think it's, I think it might be ebony, but I don't know a whole lot about that kind of thing. Ooh, slippery. Favorite songs for demonstrating a guitar and playing on the bass strings, just so you know, so you can hear whether or not it has any nice groovy bass. Mm-hmm. try that over. Fingers feel slippery.
Oh, I know why.
I was putting in silicone putty at my ma's house. Painted her bathroom, and then I needed to put the silicone around. So my fingers feel all slippery. That one. I don't even know all the variations. I did Marty's version, and I heard Angela Petrilli play it at Petrilli Picks on the interweb. And she is she's playing a lot better than me. But again, she's a professional guitar player. And I'm just a guy in his bedroom playing a cool Gibson. Making videos that six people will watch. Try that again. So I have my son's Gibson Hummingbird 1967 vintage guitar for a short period of time. And I'm going to put together a video, including this is like my bedside jam right here. I'm trying to get some recording time in before I get interrupted. Let's see how long it goes.